anyone who studies coffee.
It's about why I drink
coffee. When you see Malaysia, everywhere, like, you can see a lot of bankers or veterans in Malaysia, but when you come to Singapore, you can see, like, they are more to them, the women, and they can't easily recognize any destitute persons there, because the Singapore law is like that. When we have strict penalties, for example, Singapore Destitute Persons Act 19, in that particular section, section 4 of the Act, they stated that female recognition of our destitute act, recognition of they regarded as can't get their own money for themselves. That means they can't work, and then they can't address themselves as any employer, employee there. And then they are finding for food for the street as their place to survive. But according to the punishment, Singapore, they giving imprisonment for not exceeding 2 years' time. If they found he's begging or he's a veteran, they giving punishment of imprisonment not exceeding 2 years. And then fine 3,000 for them. But in Malaysia, the punishment is they're sending to welfare homes. If imprisonment, 3 months imprisonment. But in that welfare homes, that's the difference. So when we compare this to law, Singapore and Malaysia, Malaysia is more to encourage them to go to welfare homes so they can get anything there. They are giving, helping them rather than giving them punishment, and it's like rehabilitation. To Malaysia, but Singapore, when they punish them, they will have the effort to commit again to begging of my parents' hands.
Maybe the reason of the greatest is depend on the population of citizen. In Malaysia, we have about 54.
Tiga.
Thank you.
But in Asia, they, as a first step, they are sending them to the parents. But it's like still encouraging them to do that. If let's say in penalty, they didn't realize that they are doing the wrong thing. So after that, maybe can send to
the
solution
for the disabled person, because we don't want any beggars.